Hey, John, how are you?
And it's a good looking,
It's beautiful, just given to me by some of the people in the Shoshone tribe.
You don't seem tired at all. I don't really understand that. How is it that you're not exhausted? Well, when you get out here and do this.
When you're 36 years of age, it's not that hard, John. I mean, older people like yourself, I understand that. I'm not unsympathetic.
I'm falling apart, and you're up there like cranking it out every day. So you guys had pretty high hopes going into Tuesday's contest, right? And you got beaten 5.
No, wait a second. What you guys always do is talk about these things as a winner-take-all thing. This is not. We lost Illinois by 1 or 2 delegates. Right. Missouri, I don't know, by less or something like that. So, in fact, what we showed in Illinois and in Missouri that we do have strength, that what happened in Michigan was not a fluke.
Is it discouraging to you at all?
Hey, when we started this campaign, it was at 3% in the polls. We had none to them. We were 70 points behind.
Right.
Why would I be discouraged?
Right. Lose
would
states?
I have rather won all 5 states by landslide victories?
Sure.
Trust me, I would have.
When you hear people, as people are now starting to do, and I'm not talking about pundits, I'm talking about people in the Democratic Party, start to appeal to you to bring this thing to a close on the basis of party unity, you say what?
What I say is that Republicans win when the turnout is low, Democrats and progressives win when the turnout is high. By competing for the votes in 50 states, by energizing people in 50 states, we are laying the groundwork for a high voter turnout. We are bringing millions of people into the political process who might not have otherwise been in.
When we've talked before about your reasons for getting into this race, you talked about wanting to, that running for president was the only way to make some of these issues that you really care about central to the American political discourse. I think we would agree that you've done that, correct?
Yes.
You have pushed Secretary Clinton to the left on a lot of issues. You could say this cynically, but she is now further in the progressive direction on the record than she was when this campaign started.
Yes.
Right? You have energized millions of new voters, young voters, who now this will be their first experience in politics through you. So if you come up short, if you don't get the Democratic nomination, will this endeavor have been a success on those terms?
So yes, all of this campaign, I think, has done a lot to transform American politics, and I'm proud of that. All of those ideas now cannot be dismissed.
Right.
All right, am I proud of that? Sure I am. But that is not to say that we're not in this thing to win.
So there's nothing about this at this point, you know, people talk about Don Quixote, you know, who's both a figure of delusion and also a figure of romance, right? There's nothing quixotic about this. You don't, when you hear that description to where you are now, does that ring at all true to you?
No, we are running, look, we're taking on one of the best known people in the world who has the most powerful political organization, who has the entire establishment behind her. Believe me, I knew that when we got into this, this is not gonna be a cakewalk, this is gonna be a tough fight. I'm enormously proud of the campaign that we have run. And if you had followed me along the rope line, what you would have heard people say, thank you. Thank you for giving us hope. Thank you for expressing my views.